Switching it up a bit, we are moving over from Jurassic Park to another big franchise that has lasted almost as long, Mission Impossible. For me, I heard about Mission Impossible since I was a kid, but never saw them until the fourth one, Ghost Protocol, in IMAX, which was an amazing experience. Since then, I only saw the fifth one that came out as well, and now I'm looking forward to the sixth one, Fallout, coming out this month. With that, I thought it would be a good idea to catch up by watching the older movies. So for this, I will be going over the first Mission Impossible movie. So how did this come about? Well, if you are a bit younger, you may not know, but in the 1990s, the Mission Impossible was not a movie franchise, but a TV show from the 60s and 70s. So in the 90s, Paramount Pictures, which owned a TV show, tried to turn it into a movie, but failed a couple times. Tom Cruise, who was a big fan of the original TV show, came to the picture by going over to Paramount to convince them to make the movie with his new production company, Cruise Wagner. After talks, Paramount agreed to produce the movie with Tom Cruise's production company, with Cruise as a star of the movie, and a $70 million budget. Eventually, they hired Brian De Palma to direct, who, if you haven't heard of the name, you've definitely heard of his movies, including Carrie, Scarface, and Carlito's Way. The film's production did not have a good start, as they went into filming without a completed script that all parties agreed on. It was also, in fact, De Palma that convinced Cruise to have the first big set piece happen in Prague. However, things improved, and overall they were able to commit to the script and finish the movie on time and under budget. It would be released on May 22, 1996, and would gross $180 million domestic and $457 million worldwide. To give that some perspective, it was the third highest movie domestically that year, only behind Independence Day and Twister. So, what did I think of the movie? Well, for the most part, I did like it. But when I first started watching it, it was a bit of a shock to the system, from going to 4 and 5 to the first. Anyway, what I liked about it was the setup of Cruise's character being framed and on the run. The set pieces, especially the teams infiltrating the CIA headquarters, was really good. However, the finale at the end with the chopper in the train tunnel did not age well, and wasn't honestly that exciting. It felt like when the team had to do actual spy stuff and maybe doing heists, like at the CIA headquarters, that's where the characters shined and the movie was at its best. It also shines with the characters as well. Besides Tom Cruise, Vig Rames is also good in this, and I can see why he stayed around in the franchise. Overall, the first Mission Impossible is a fun movie to watch, and it's a good start to the franchise. Overall, the first Mission Impossible movie is a fun movie to watch, and while some parts of it may not have held up, it is absolutely worth a watch, especially if you're looking forward to the new one coming out in a few weeks. Anyways, that is it for this week of Summer Movie Throwbacks. Thank you for listening.